Dick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the Louisiana Lafayette Ragin' Cajuns and the Auburn Tigers.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Tigers are the highly favored team in this one, Dick. Still, what are the keys for the game?
Well, the keys should be simple tonight, Brad. Number one, I look at the point guard to step up tonight and really take control of his club. Second, pound the ball inside. Challenge their big men. And finally, it's imperative that you win the battle of the boards.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Right in the circle.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Trying to draw the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. They look to get it to the inside. Perfectly executed.
I think right now, gotta focus defensively.
The small forward handles the feed. And he tries to spin away and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Well, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
They work it around the perimeter.
High post screen. Going to use it.
The shot from the baseline. Makes it. Hale handles the pass. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It is too much for him, and he lost possession.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. The Tigers go to the line for the first time in this game. Gets the first shot. And he got them both. They'll work it around the arc. Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
Good rebound position. Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Moving it around the perimeter. The small forward receives the ball.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Auburn are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together here.
Yeah, they're really starting to click on offense. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Hale receives the pass. He shoots from the elbow. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
This is a one-man show right now, Brad. This is supposed to be a team game.
Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Can't get the shot to go.
STOP. This place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
The point guard gets the ball. Number 32 with the fake. Those long arms trying to get him in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Gave it up. He attempts the three. Nice shot. Erickson is seemingly at an emotional low point at this moment, Dick.
He needs to take a deep breath, refocus, and get after it.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
High post flashes for the opportunity. Goes up for two.
He made good use of the screen, but the shot fell off.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
As the fans continue to chant.
Well, ultimately, the goal is to win. The crowd feels as though they are a big part of it, too.
Drains it. Shot clock is dead. Dumps it in. The power forward takes the feed. He goes with a jump hook. Doesn't go. Number 32 draws the personal. This is the team's first trip to the free throw line.
Concentrate. Got to concentrate on that free throw line.
Second shot, no good. The point guard gets the pass.
Trying to go inside. Great anticipation defensively.
Attempts the Hail Mary. No luck finding the basket the last few trips down court, Dick.
What they need are some easy layups or a couple of nice putbacks.
Time, the Raging Cajuns are behind by seven. We've had a very tight contest tonight, Dick. What's your highlight of the half?
I picked the kind of highlight that only a coach can love, Brad. His team working the ball down low to their big man, putting inside basket.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's see how this one unfolds. Auburn is shooting very well from the floor right now, Dick.
They're getting good looks, man, and they're not letting them go to waste. That's how you win games, man. Offensive execution.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Erin. He'll regroup the offense. Good fake. He shoots from the top of the circle. It's no good. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
And in and out. Gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
Trying to feed inside. Picks off the pass. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player, and they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Jumps into the defender, drops the bucket despite the harm. I isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Intercepted. He keeps the dribble as they reset.
Nice high post screen.
Louisiana Lafayette are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they've put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up. 5 second call approaching.
The center with the ball. He launches the bomb. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench. No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
For the deuce, contact causes the shot to come off. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Takes the pass in the paint. There's a double team waiting there. Dick, the tournament seems like it's so tight. These two teams have showed that they belong. They played great in the first half, and now it's going to come down to the wire, it looks like.
Hey, Brad, I think this is going right to the finish line with the last possession. Whoever gets the ball last, I think, is going to win this baby. I mean, they're making every big shot, both these clubs.
The point guard takes the pass. He makes the block. On the outside. Well, partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified. It could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Timeout. Let's check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie. I wouldn't mind seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either.
The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad.
Picked off. The point guard gets the ball. Picked out of the air. Pushes it up. The shooting guard gets the pass. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
He intercepts it. And a momentary look from three-point land. And we've got a whistle and a foul. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
Short steps to the line for the first time. Misses the first. Misses the second. Picks it out of the air.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
I think it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
In the paint. Kicks it out. Takes away the pass. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. The small forward takes the feed. He's got a nice shot fake. That is a key play at this point in the game, Dick.
Right, Brad. A very heads-up play to get the ball back when they desperately need a basket.
That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Defensive foul two. Lockhart.
clock stop with a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
And yet another foul. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
Everything looked good but the result. We'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
He shoots from outside. Rims out.
They have to foul to send them to the line and hope they miss.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, I tell you, win this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Auburn came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
Brad Nessler saying,